full story of Kahn's Tiger City had not been told. I was going to travel in Kahn's footsteps to see what he saw, experience what he experienced in order to understand how this American architect came to South Asia to build his masterpiece.
It's an architectural marvel. We are very proud of that building. That's our parliament, and Bangladesh being a democratic country, we think our parliament is housed in the right building.
Straddling design and philosophy, he has left an indelible imprint on the world as one of the great visionary architects of his time.
Welcome to Bangladesh Parliament.
Beginning with the Yale Art Gallery, everything he did was for an institution of higher purpose. The Salk Institute, we were supposed to cure cancer. The Exeter Library was all about the idea of learning. The assembly building in Dhaka, this was a birth of democracy.
Kahn was idealistic. He did believe that architecture fundamentally changes how you occupy a space. I mean, it's the idea of, you know, the thoughts that you have in Rome aren't the thoughts that you have in Paris.
What does a brick want to be? See, the issue was, what do things want to be, not what are they? So he became a kind of a creator, a conspirator with the material.
Kahn was also a deeply committed architect who wanted to create architecture, buildings that would be timeless. A place has a spirit, and the architect's role is to condense that spirit into the building.
How does a person use their light? Their own light, the light that's given to them. And sometimes you can find the light in the nature of a place, and sometimes you have to make a path.
How had Louis Kahn built such a daringly modern and monumental building in this culturally rich but economically shattered country? How had an Estonian-born American who was known as an architect's architect managed to win such a high-profile commission nearly 10,000 miles from his home in Philadelphia?
Weeping inside Louis Kahn's building is not too uncommon.
It has a visceral presence that is overwhelming. I shed a tear for him, for it, for the idea that human beings would have the audacity to make something like that.
Many times, linkages come from far away, unknown sources. And I think those are the sources which link time and space. And that is where the real creativity happens. Kahn always talked about being a fool. If you remain a child, you have all the possibilities to do what you want to do.
From the first theories of beauty and that of wonder which follows it, comes realization. And realization stems from the way we were made. Because we had to employ all the laws of the universe to be. And we hold within us the record of the decisions which made us particularly humans. There is the psychic record, there is the physical record, and the choices that we made to satisfy this desire to be, which directed itself to what we now are. I believe that this nucleus lies in the leaf, it lies in the microbe, it lies in everything living.